Hello, my dear baby, and welcome back to the party camp. So I have now Duncan's set of weapon, while Alistair is having Merrick and Kaelin and Warden commander weapon. Okay. Well, oh, then you can keep your cup for now. Well, yeah, Leliana is the only person other than Toby and Shale that doesn't have a hat. Okay.
Are you sure I can't interest you? I'm sure.
And so I can sell this crossbow since there is no purpose of it. The longbow could be. I could give it to Zephron. Shunter belt. If I want to have a belt, then there is one here. And then there are these amulets here. I mean, I think, yeah, some of these apprentice amulet and whatnot I sold, yeah, and now I can buy them back for much more, because this buyback only works to things that you sold just now, not things you sold earlier, which is stupid. I don't like it. But yeah, I don't need any of that. I could need some of the crafting materials, I guess. But yeah, I'm fine with how the party is. I have a single fire arrow remaining. Probably I should give it to Leliana. Oh yeah, I was thinking about enchantment time.
Enchantment.
Okay, so let's see. So disenchant everything. Let's start with that. So we need to disenchant everything. So Alistair's weapon is the one that always equipped. Almost always. So this should have the best that I have. So yeah, plus 8 damage by the darkspawn. Cool. Plus 8 versus undead. Just plus 4 electricity. So these are the choices. There's also a Silverite, which is expert, which is, you know, almost as good. Cold iron, that's good against undead. Cold is good against undead, it's strange. Physical resistance. Lightning damage. Is this plus 15 physical assistance any good? I don't know. But yeah, this is something that will always be affecting Alistair. Because Alistair always have it enabled, equipped. While the others not. So having plus 15 resistance in the rune would be, you know, good for Alistair because he have it always. So for Leliana or John having this and then we are having both on, then it means that it's not in use. I don't know. Yeah, I guess I can use this. Plus 15 resistance. Let's check out what Alistair is like. Plus 64. Yeah.
Enchantment?
Then the Duncan Sword plus 6. That is Darkspawn. And I could have this other one plus 15 physical resistance for me, and then the dagger. Plus 4. That is Darkspawn. We have this Master Cold Iron against undead, but this is probably something good for Redcliffe. There we fought against a lot of. So yeah, this doesn't mean a lot if we are not fighting against undead. And with the Silver Light, we are very often fighting against Darkspawn, so that's, you know, most of the time good. But then the lightning rune is just gives electricity damage, which could be good against many things. Although could be resisted. And this have spell resistance, but 5-6%, that doesn't seem very good. So what should be it? Spell resistance 6%. Or I could just have more extra damage against Darkspawn, yeah, okay. Nella Eliana. Guess can have this plus 8 lightning, and instead would have the undead bonus. And then the spare resistance, maybe, I don't know. Yeah. Okay. Do we wanna keep any of these? No. No. So I will give these to the mages. Okay.
And so I shall.
Alright, all the journeymans. And the novitions.
You are wise to invest in the effectiveness of your followers.
Thank you. And so we are set up now. What remains is leveling up, of course, all the characters. In my place, I just could pick one more specialization. I mean, really, do I wanna wait for Assassin? Well, yeah, the very first Assassin trait is good, the Mark of Death. So, yeah. Especially since Leliana will be with me, no point in two rangers. Okay. Mr. 2 could be a berserker, but I will wait. And then Shea no level up, and Ogren could pick be a Templar. But I will not. And then Leliana got a level up. Okay. So what do we want? We have the 20 strength that we need for the armor. 34 dexterity, 26. Yeah. So Leliana uses a lot of stamina, have a lot of talents, so we need more. I mean, some of the rogue talents use cunning, so more cunning would be good too, but yeah, the stamina is really needed. So maybe put it like this. Okay. And then a talent. Just like with the two stealing skills, the two tool. A talent is wasted. It's unfortunate. And so I got all of these. I got Summon Wolf. I could get the bar things. Could get combat movement or deadly strike, but yeah, Leliana is not melee, so no. I could get the summon bear spider or this line. Now the thing is that we are not summoning additional creatures, right? We are just, instead of wolf, we summon a bear. So destruction can disorient a target unless it passes mental resistance check for 45 stamina. That's a lot. Yeah, I think this one is pretty much required for dual weapon. Now this is closer to normal damage bonus. The open weapon. So yeah, I guess I will just pick this up, so then I can be better with handling the two weapons. Okay. Let's continue. Ogren. But yeah, I already was here. Leliana and Vin. Another level up. So we have the 40 magic. We don't need anything more, right? We are going for the Mono Clash. Yeah, 33 magic. Oh, and we can get it with this level up. Cool! I have been waiting for that. So, we don't exactly need more magic, but any more points we put in magic will increase the... the spell power. We don't need constitution, we just gave it. Yeah, the plus 12 constitution gives us more constitution than our base constitution is. Wow. So yeah, we can just increase the willpower by 3, and we already counteracted the minus 3 from the thingy. Yeah, fine. There you go. And we got the Talon. Yeah, I could, you know, still get the Arcane Warrior thing, but not before Mono Clash. Now this should make all the spellcasting enemies easy to deal with. Cover completely drained of mana and suffer spirit damage proportional to the amount of mana that they lost. Yeah. I love it. Thing is, we have to increase this one more for the mono class. Although this mono clearance I basically can put out of this, because why would I use this instead of the mono class, which just needs 10 more? Well, with this I can, you know, basically kill one spellcaster, but there are maybe more. Mono clearance nullifies the number of enemies in an area, so yeah, potentially this still have use, okay. Where to put this? Where put this? No. I wanna post it to the number one spot because this sounds really useful. Expels large amount of mana in direct opposition to enemy spellcasters who are completely drained of mana and suffer spirit damage proportional to the amount of mana they lost. Yeah. 40 second cooldown, so this means that yeah, I could use this to kill one and then use this to neutralize all the rest. And we also have spell might, which we picked up, making spells more useful, expanding mana rapidly. Okay. Alright, let's do our safety save just in case. And Vin, and then Morrigan, who gets power, 3 level ups, 9 points to attribute. We got the 40 magic, we don't need constitution or any of these, we can just put this in willpower. Like that. Although yeah, once again, it is perfectly fine to increase the magic, then we will be able to have more powerful spells. The willpower, you know, mana can be just replaced with the potions. But I think it is fine. We have more willpower. And yeah, we picked up Spirit Healer just for the specialization bonus. And we get a skill. And so Morrigan is our master herbalist. There is no reason for her to pick poison making because she doesn't use melee weapons. So the poison would not work. We can go for the survival line for nature resistant and physical resistant at the last, or we can go for more combat training. So level 2 was good. All of them increases the amount of damage needed to interrupt, and level 2 gives bonus to mana regeneration. So yeah, level 3 and 4 just increases damage needed to interrupt. Yeah, I mean, if our mage is interrupted, then that's not good. However, the mage should not be interrupted because that's why we have tanks. Yeah. So I'm not going to go for this. I'm going to go for the nature resistances. Yeah, I mean, with the warriors and the orcs, it's clear you want this, but with the mage, it's not clear. Yeah, you want tier 2. Maybe not the rest. Yeah, I mean, if this would just say, you know, it gives a small bonus to mana regeneration or something, then it would be clear. Okay, we want this. But this way, just to increase, you know, what it takes to interrupt. Yeah, we haven't been really interrupted ever, so no, I'm just going to go for survival. Although, yeah, Morgan doesn't have the cunning for the levels of survival, and I am certainly not going to divert points. Right, but Morrigan can have two of these. Yeah. I really don't know. Yeah, I don't think these are really useful. Let's just go for survival. But yeah, the problem is that cunning is cutting us off. I could go for poison making, really. That doesn't need cunning, very strangely. And then it would make Morrigan our, you know, brewer master. We would not need Zevran. Yeah, let's go for poison making, because there is really, you know, it's alright. It does mean it's a little pity that we didn't went for the Arcane Warrior, because then with the poison making an Arcane Warrior, we could have a mage with poisoned swords and whatnot. But that's okay. And so we got three spells to pick. And so with Morrigan, we didn't go for the Monoclash. We went for the Waking Nightmare and Death Cloud. And yeah, we went for this line. The Dead Siphon and Virulent Walking Board and Animated Dead. And we also have Spirit Healer, but we are not going to take it. Yeah. Dead Siphon. Virulent Walking Board and Animate Dead. And the tactics got acquired. I will, you know, if I will ever use Morrigan, I will make sure to do that. That Siphon, that's another healing move, self healing move. No, that's not healing, that's mana. So that's actually more useful, because we should not need to heal. But if we need to heal, we have drain life to drain life from other living things, and we have that magic which will heal us from the dead around us. And that siphon is almost the same, but it will get us mana from dead around us. So yeah, these two, like the dead magic, will, you know, get stronger the more we progress in battle and we will have more enemies around us. So yeah, with this we can regenerate mana in combat, pretty useful. And the virulent walking bomb is just a superior version of the normal walking bomb. create have 10 more mana cost, but it's way superior. So I probably should not, you know, even use it really. Okay, that's Morrigan. Zevran, let's get 3 level ups too. Does Zevran have, yeah, Zevran have lethality, so yes, I know. Zevran, so yeah, we don't need strength, we already have 20, that's enough. So we need cunning, willpower for stamina and dexterity for attacks. I think cunning is very low for Zevran. I mean low for Leliana too, but Leliana excuse me. Leliana is not a cunning based rogue. So yeah, it doesn't have these stealth moves and these. Yeah, the bard is cunning based, but she doesn't have that either. And the bear, the summoning is not cunning based. Neither the archery. So yeah. So Leliana is not a cunning based rogue, but Zevran is. That one have the stat, have these. So yeah, the evasion is 35 dexterity. That might need. This needs 36 dexterity. So yeah, we need dexterity for sure. 36 for this. This doesn't need dexterity. So yeah, we need at least 36 dexterity, that's established. And yeah, the stealth needs cunning, I think. That is true that cunning modifies it, and cunning modifies, you know, because we have the lethality too. So, Zevran, we need at least 36 dexterity, that's we got. Might need more stamina, but we also pretty soon we need more cunning. How much more cunning? I don't know. Maybe 26. one with willpower, one a little more stamina maybe. Alright, okay, that's a deal. We got a skill unlock, that will be only survival, can it be? We got the Mark Stealth, that's very good. We are far apart from the Dual Weapon Mastery. Far away. We could get evasion, yeah. Okay, I will get evasion. Yeah, because these I don't like at all. But yeah, the first assassin trait is actually, you know, decent. Marks target, all attacks against marked target deal additional damage. Yes, you know, that sounds fine. Especially, you know, against a boss. So yeah, against a single difficult target, this is good. But this... Oh. Okay. Oh no, I have two more talents. So yeah, if I don't take evasion, I could get to Dual Weapon Mastery, which will enable Zervan to use two full-size weapons. That sounds badass, two sword. Or I could get evasion and I could get... So yeah, the exploit weakness is situational but not that bad. So if we have a successful backstab attack, it gains additional damage based on cunning. We already need more cunning to make stealth more effective, at least that's my impression. Loss of eight. Backstab deals enough damage. Feast of the Fallen. Yeah, this is just bull. This is just bullcrap. This is just completely, you know, ridiculous. Stamina is partially recovered when the assassin fails the opponent with a backstab. So the assassin needs to do the finishing blow and it needs to be a backstab. So yeah, you know, go to hell. I mean, what the chance of this actually happening? Yeah. So either I could go for this, or I could get this, or there's evasion, or there is the duelist line too. Or I could just get this, or I could get this. Dual striking, riposte, triple, punisher. I don't know. Or I could get, you know, up here to King Defense. Or I could get this, I mean, really, the options are really a lot of options. Yeah, that's the evasion, I like it. I think, yeah, so this is the most useful, yeah. I think these four are progressively getting less and less useful. So yeah, this is, you know, always useful. You can put this against anything, but most useful against a single hard enemy. And the next exploit weakness, you know, during a successful backstab, additional damage. So yeah, it's situational, it needs a backstab. But well, you know, you can, you know, get those, especially with the stat. So yeah, situational, but you know, the situation, you know, can happen, you know. But then the loss of it, the backstab deals enough damage, then additional damage for a short time. And then this, you need to be the finishing blower and to do the finishing blow with a backstab. So. Go to hell. And for part, yeah, restoration of stamina, it's, yeah. I don't know. Yeah, probably get to Alice and get on this line. Or, you know, if I don't want to be too much like me, although I do have these two. I could go down this line too. Or I could have this, because I have this backstab helping moves. And this at least works anytime there is a backstab, which can happen. So yeah, okay, let's put 1 point here. And yeah, let's put 1 point in dueling. Okay. So that was everyone. Oh, and it's all 40 minutes, so let's end the episode here. I didn't even finish, wow. Well, I hope you had some fun. See you next time. Bye bye.